A popular rock band from Nagaland About Us, which has garnered the attention nationally and internationally with its smashing single Kimi Kimi, has once again enthralled the crowd at the 23rd edition of the Hornbill Music Festival. Well, Hornbill TV had an exclusive interaction with the band after the performance. Let's have a look.
Watching Hornbill TV, as you can see, the musical fest and Hornbill Musical Fest just ended, and here we are with us. We have the band About Us. I've been trying so hard to get an interview with them, and I finally got the chance to talk to them. So they are here with us. Thank you so much, all of you, for joining us and agreeing to speak to us today.
Thank you so much.
Before we just want to know more about the band. So would you tell us more about the band, the members, and everybody here?
You have to talk about the band, and the band started in the year 2019, so this is us, just the six of us. So from there, from my right, it's Ren on the lead guitar, Mr. Ren Martin on the keyboard, Mr. Pon on the rhythm guitar, Mr. Yanni on the drums, me as a vocal, Suchan, and him as Soren on the bass.
May I know when the band was formed, just the lineup that you have now, when was it? The official
formation of the band was in the year 2019. So in the late 2019, end of 2019. That's where we released our debut single, Loaded Love. Yeah, that was the month where.
Maybe it was the end of 2019, and I think in the next year the pandemic was there, and we didn't have the Hornbill Festival after that. Is this your first time here as a band performing? Was this your first time performing?
Yeah. After forming the band About Us, you know, we have to undergo the pandemic. We were supposed to perform last year with Kirish and the Chronicles, but the outing incident, it called off. So it is the first time, yeah. But and we are glad to be here, yes.
How was the experience? I also want to know about the preparations. How was the preparation? Since when did you guys practice, or how was it made?
The practice session that goes along between us, I mean, like, it's always there, you know. We always meet up and like we jam on the songs, the numbers that we want to perform. That's always there. There has been always.
Besides the band, besides playing music, may I also know what all of you does in your life? I mean, what do you do in?
I'm an assistant director in social welfare. Yeah.
I'm a full-time musician.
I'm a music mentor.
Yeah, I'm an entrepreneur. Well, I'm employed in NHM.
I'm currently a senior DA in the Department of Treasuries in the GAUMS.
So with all the work, I also want to know, how do you guys get the time to practice? And also, as I'm aware that you guys have been going around touring and playing shows, how do you guys take out the time?
I see, it's a balance between the work and, you know, the passion that you follow. It doesn't overlap, right? It go hand in hand with the other one.
Yeah. That's what it is. I mean, like, the passion leads us here. I mean, yeah, like, each and every one of us. The passion for music.
Will you guys be here till the 10th, or will you be leaving? Or what is the plan?
We'll be leaving tomorrow, because we have a show coming up on the 10th of December in Joy.
Shillong,
yeah. So we'll be leaving tomorrow, by tomorrow.
As a band, we could say that you guys are one of the most loved rock band here in Nagaland. So we would also want to know, where do you guys draw your inspiration from? Is there any band as such from Nagaland, or is there any other international bands, rock bands? From whom do you draw inspiration?
For that, I mean, like, I'll just leave up to our individual preferences, because each and every one of us, we are from different varied background. So, like, we all have drawn influence from varied bands, you know, that I would say.
It varies from one member to another.
Yeah.
And also, see, we draw inspiration from each other, the way we work hard, the way we love each other as a band. You know, see, we are six brothers, okay? We are not, so that's how we draw inspiration from ourselves. I mean, the passion we have for music, the love we have for one another. I think that's the whole concept of the, you know, of the thing behind the band. So, that's
when it comes to the Hornbill Festival, music concerts, like we said, we don't have as much music concerts like we used to have before. So how important do you think the Hornbill Festival is, the Hornbill Music Festival is for all the artists and also bands like yours? How big of an opportunity or a platform is it?
Uh, for us as a band, we take it as a platform for us to be here and like to perform in front of new people, because there's not just our people that's coming out here. So there are so many tourists that's coming out and like witnessing the, I mean, I would say like in a way a spectacular, I mean like there are so many bands and performers out here performing. So in that way, like I believe like we are in up to something for like a bigger thing. Not just a stage and where we're performing, yeah.
I think the government is doing a lot of good job by bringing in the local music with that of the international bands, you know, that comes to play. For example, if you look about the international band like Kirita playing here, so you know it's a kind of inspiration that the local bands can draw from. You know, when we were before turning about us, we were also in a local band, so we used to look up to Hornbill as something that comes along our way, you know. So that's sort of that sort of passion that we have in us. So obviously it's a great stage for any inspiring musicians. Right. Yeah, it is definitely.
Since you guys said that the band was formed at in 2019, may I also know what are the changes that you guys see in the band? What are the changes that you see, improvements or things as such? Anybody or any one of you?
I mean, one of the first thing is that he's still bachelor. He's always been bachelor.
So that's the thing where there's no change.
Exactly.
The only change that we can see in us is that we are getting older. That's it. That's the only changes that we can see. I mean, like on a lighter note.
Yes. Yeah, definitely he's right. The love remains the same. The bond remains the same. We grow older every year. Yeah, he's right. Definitely.
What about skills and also live performances? Do you guys think there are changes? You guys have improved or any improvement changes as such also?
Yeah, definitely. See, live performances improve day by day. You know, after every performance, we evaluate where we go wrong. We evaluate each and every show. It doesn't matter if we have a great show, but we'll still evaluate because we want to be at the top of the game. Yeah, definitely. That is the...
Like I've mentioned earlier also about the Hornbill Festival, the music festival being important or a good opportunity and a platform for talented artists and musicians. Do you see any changes in that? The Hornbill Festival, the music festival being, changes in the music festival?
I think a lot of international bands are coming now. We have bands from Israel coming. So I think there's a lot of changes that are coming up because music is growing. The stature of the Hornbill is growing. So you need international band to craze the and also upgrade the standard. So definitely that's happening, yes.
If I'm not wrong, you guys also released a song just some few months ago. Am I right? Yeah, a few weeks ago. So tell us more about that, or that song. Also, we would like to know more about what it is about and things as such.
He's the guy.
Okay. Fairyland.
The whole album, the Fairyland.
I would say like it's a feel good music in the first place. It's more like on the, I mean, melodic side of the rock thing. Like we have been doing that. The music that we usually, I mean, like we are going for currently, like. We are going for melodic rock, so musically that's the side of it, and then lyrically the vocalist, he wrote the lyrics, so I think he will have more to say about the song, like lyrically, story behind it, than I, so it's better if you ask him.
The question was thrown to you, so I'd like to know why the meaning behind the lyrics. What is the song about?
I wrote the lyric. It's all fictional, I would say. It was not intended as such. I heard the melody first, and then only after hearing the melody, I just came up with those lines. Like it was not pre-planned. It's not something like I already had it in mind, but it was something that I, after hearing the melody, and I just put it on like about it, two lovers, you know, like having to have a good time with each other. That's the basic thing about the song. Our Fairyland is all about that. That's it.
Also, I've seen the music videos, and you guys are always, when it comes to your music, the music video is always top notch. I would also want to know, how important do you think now these days it is for a music video to be good, to also sell the song or to even make the music?
It's an internet-driven world, okay? So the visual and the audio has to be very good. You can't survive just by playing a good music, no. Now you need to draw the audience to your good music, to the code, the visual aspect of it. So we need to balance both. And you see, there is the hard work we put in behind the scene. You can see how hard we are working on the visual aspect of the song. So we take both element, the audio and the visual, very strongly. So that has helped us to come up to this level. Yes, definitely. Yes.
Is there anything you would want to add to that?
Rock on.
That's the basic thing.
Yeah, that's the best thing.
Lastly, as a band, like I've mentioned, you guys have been getting a lot of love and attention, not even only here in Nagaland, but also people from outside the state. I've also watched other people reacting to your music videos and all. When you guys started, did you guys expect to get so much love and support? How is it?
I won't say like we expected such kind of a big thing from the, you know, listeners, but we always believed in our music. The moment we started, we believed in our music, and like we knew, I won't say like we aimed for a bigger thing, but I would always say like we knew that we are up for something big, and that's what we are heading towards it. We still think that we haven't reached the place, the position that we want to be. Yeah. So we are still heading, we are still doing our best. So like that's it. I mean, like, we're still doing it.
So what is
we're
it?
We're still trying. We're triers.
Since you said you're trying, may I know what is the ultimate goal? What is that?
There's no ultimate goal. Yeah, also, totally. Like, there's nothing such as, like, there's a goal about music, because music, it ends. Music is endless. Mm-hmm, there's everything is irreplaceable. Somebody will come and go.
The sky is the limit. So we cannot draw the limit, right? So we just dream it. The dream was there to reach somewhere place. But the moment you reach another place, you'll find that there's another mountain to climb. So it's definitely endless. So that's a dream for us.
We're still chasing our peak. Yeah. That's it.
May I also know, what do you think about it? Were you expecting so much love and support from the audience when you guys formed the band? I just want to...
The love from the audience. Okay, yes, we do. We do want that. Because without that love, we aren't going anywhere. We aren't going anywhere. So the love and the affection that that's therein. And in fact, there's a song in our album, Love and Affection, and I think that relates a lot on that.
Lastly, would you like to, do you have any messages to your fans?
All we can say is like, just keep believing in yourself and just keep rocking on top. That's it, you know?
Yeah, that's it.
Keep the faith.
Yeah,
yeah,
the faith.
Rock on top.
Rock on top.
Give us a hint on the next album as well, could you?
Yeah, we're working
on it. When is it releasing? And
I mean, like, we haven't decided about the release, but we are working on it.
Yeah, working on it.
We're already working on it.
But very soon.
Before the end of the year, or shall we expect?
No. It'll be next year only. Yeah. Okay, I
think that's all we'll have for now. Thank you so much, all of you, for joining me today.
It was a pleasure having you.
It was I've always wanted to have a conversation, and I'm thankful that I got the opportunity today. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
That's all we have for now. Keep watching Hornbilltv.